Hi there! I'm sure that everyone already heard about the latest image generation model FLUX, which is so impressive that we can simply call it a Midjourney and Stable Diffusion killer. After this video, you will be able to use FLUX and generate everything privately in the cloud. And I know it sounds a bit controversial, but nevertheless, you can do it on any device, including a phone, in one click, with no GPU required and for free. More importantly, you can generate images in a Google Colab, Lightning AI, Kaggle, Amazon SageMaker, and any other GPT-like environment which provides access to free GPU. I know it sounds too good to be true, however, it's true and I did it for you guys. But for now, let's briefly discuss why FLUX is so cool. First, and to my mind, the most important is the exceptional prompt following. Do you want to image a cat in a Rome legionary uniform? No problem. Do you want to image a cat in a Rome legionary uniform sitting on a black leather sofa? Also no problem. With a glass of beer in a hand? Of course. And for some reason with Coliseum in the background? Yes, sure. And with a cat woman sitting on the left? Well, it's probably a cat woman, but not the cat woman. Seems that we achieved the limit. But you can disagree that we've never had something close before, especially in open source models. It's just mind-blowing result. What more special in FLUX? It also generates high-quality images in only 1 to 4 steps. Chill version with 12 billion parameters released under Apache True license. The model can be used for personal, scientific and commercial purposes. Well, the most important part, how to finally generate images with FLUX. For this, you should go to Google Colab, press File, New Notebook in Drive. Then you should go by the link below under this video to my Patreon, which is available for free for everyone without registration. But if you want to support me and what I'm doing, you are welcome to do so. Here you should copy these 4 lines of code. Press Copy and paste it here in this cell. Then we should choose runtime, change runtime type, of course with T4 GPU, and just press run button. That's it. It takes about up to 5 minutes to load all needed requirements and models, and then some kind of UI will be available for you and you can generate any images with FLUX. And let's do the same with Lightning AI. I think you already got it how it works. Just press New Studio here, press Start. Here you should choose GPU instance, L4 is the best one, and we will discuss a bit later why. And just wait a little bit to load your new project. Alright, here press Notebook Python 3, and in this notebook, past previous code. Now we should wait a little bit to get our GPU. L4 is ready, let's press Switch. Then open once again untitled notebook and execute this cell. That's it. Here we've got a warning, disk is almost full, it's okay, just ignore it. And here we've got our user interface. Here you can enter your prompt, let it be a cat once again. You should choose also a step, let it be 1, resolution. And to generate images, obviously just press generate button. Unfortunately, FLUX required a lot of GPU resources. T4 is not so fast GPU for FLUX. It takes about up to 5 minutes to generate an image, the same situation with Kaggle. In case of Lightning AI, we have much more powerful GPU, NVIDIA Tesla L4, and we can generate images much faster. So, to my mind, Lightning AI is the best option for you. Here we can choose even 4 steps and just press generate button. Here we go, we've got our results and it looks not so bad. It takes about 2 minutes to generate an image. Here you can see an image in a full resolution. It has only 1 step, it already looks really, really nice. But of course, if you want to achieve better quality, choose about 4 steps for this version of model. Well, Lightning AI works much faster because it has much more powerful GPU NVIDIA Tesla L4. And in this case, it generates image with 4 steps with standard resolution in 18 seconds, which is a really, really nice result. Also important to mention that this some kind of user interface not violating any rules of Google Colab, because it's just a widget-based user interface. And you can use it without fearing of being banned by Google Colab. And I think this is really nice. That's all for now. Thanks for watching and bye-bye.